YouTube. It is just a glorious late May day here on the Niagara River, and I'm aboard my 24-foot Larson Cabrio pocket cruiser to give you part two of the application of my solar power generator project that I recently completed. I'm standing on the bow of the boat and looking over the bimini top, and what you can see is that I've placed my 100-watt Renogy flexible photovoltaic solar panel on top of that bimini. It's simply bungee cord attached to four points on the bimini frame. It is quite secure. I was out yesterday and traveling at about 25 knots, and that panel never moves, so I'm quite confident that whether I'm at anchor on the hook or underway, that panel is going to be just fine up on top of the bimini. Let's go aboard and I'll show you how this has been attached to the solar power generator that's down below in the cabin. Welcome aboard. What we have done is simply run the cables from up top of that bimini where that solar panel is located down alongside of, again, the framing and structure for the bimini top. The cable runs along the helm here and simply down to the floor and then into the cabin, where you'll find we have placed the portable solar power generator. Right now I have it up on a pedestal just so it's easier for everyone to see, but eventually it will be down in this well that is in the foreview here, so that it is out of the way and secure when we are underway. Again, I did have it out yesterday. We were cruising along for about 3 hours at an average of 20 to 25 knots, and as you might imagine, with the weight of those batteries, this portable solar power generator isn't going anyplace. It's very stable and secure inside the boat. You'll notice a couple of upgrades that I've made since I posted the last video. You'll notice on both the left and the right sides of the case on the front that there are a couple of more features. Basically what I've installed is two more terminals for alternate distribution of power. There are heavy duty remote battery terminals covered by the large red and black covers there. In the event that the boat needed a jump start, I could attach jumper cables to this generator and jump start the boat very efficiently. There's also a couple of other terminals with screw-on knobs, again both positive and negative, in the event that I'd like to attach an even larger external inverter. Right now, as you might recall, under the top here there is a 400-watt pure sine wave inverter, and at some point I may upgrade and simply carry along inside of the cabin a 1200 to 600-watt inverter for applications that require a little bit more electricity to be generated, AC power to be generated. Right now, the portable solar power generator, again, is charging. It's showing about 13.8 or 13.9 volts. And it is currently charging my netbook, which I use for navigation purposes, and you can see we're drawing about 0.2 amps. It's showing 107 volts, and you can see again where this is placed inside the cabin. There is my netbook that is currently being charged, and I think that this portable solar power generator application is going to work out exactly as I intended for my purposes, primarily on this pocket cruiser, but also for camping purposes as well. Thanks for taking a look, and for those of you who are considering building your own, I wish you best with your projects, and thanks for having a look at mine.